Welcome to another On The Road edition for WHCA. My name is Kevin Tucci. I'm here with a special guest.
Virginia Hunter.
She's my sidekick today. We're here at the Vans Warped Tour. On The Road, we're bringing you a special edition. What are you looking forward to seeing today?
Kill Switch Engaged, Under Oath is one of them.
Sexy.
So, I mean, there's a whole lot of bands here. I mean, Lucky 13 is definitely, you know, this is going to be it. We have, I'd say like 30 bands are here today.
Easily 30 bands.
Yeah.
Coheed and Cambria, just to name a few. So stay tuned. I think Spill Canvas, just to name a few. So stay tuned. You're watching On The Road with WHCA. Don't go far. Welcome back. We're here again with more interviews at the Warped Tour. Lucky 13, baby. And I'm here with Matt Jason from Cheetos. Guys, what's up?
Chilling. Hanging out, having a good time.
It would help if I put this on.
Oh, right. Sorry.
No, it's my fault. I'm the bonehead with the mic. What's up, guys? Tell us what the tour. Now, have you been on the tour since the beginning? Did you come in at some time, kind of like a you know, June? Or when did it all start for you?
It all started right from the beginning. What was it, June 29th?
Yeah, sounds right.
Yeah.
Maybe 30th.
But it's been a hell of a trip.
Has it really?
Yeah.
Now, is this one of the biggest tours that you've been on to date, or would you say that you may have bigger ones in the future coming up?
I'd say
definitely the biggest. I mean, the crowds at Warped Tour are probably the biggest crowds, other than, like, international stuff. As far as, like, international festivals, I heard those are pretty big, like Leeds and stuff like that, but we never played it, so.
Okay, now is this your first year on Warped Tour, or were you on last year?
We were on last year for like 3 weeks.
Yeah.
And what was that? So that's kind of like, it's like dipping your toe in the water and going, yeah. Oh, wait till next year. What's it like the 3 weeks last year? Now you guys have been hanging for, God, how many weeks?
Seven?
A lot.
It's gone by really fast.
Yeah, it's gone by really fast. Every day is kind of a blur. Yeah, this is probably the most fun tour to be on.
Really?
There's no like set schedule every day. It's wake up, you find out when you play, and I mean, every day is different. So it's not like every other tour where every day might seem like the same day.
So it kind of beats the every day if you had to get up at 8 o'clock in the morning and go in. And this is where it's at.
Exactly. No 9-to-5er here.
Talk to me about your music. As far as you guys got how would you describe your music to those who would be able to? I mean, you're on a tour here where there's a fine, you could be mistaken for postcore and actually be screamo. You know what I mean? What would you classify your music as?
Barfcore.
It's so hard to. That's like the hardest question. I mean, we don't really try to write a certain style. We just kind of if we have an idea, we kind of run with it, and it turns out a certain way. It turns out a certain way. But we try to be as diverse as possible, really. So diverse core.
What would you say your influences have been as far as that? If we were to hear a Cheetos tune, who would we hear inflected in that music?
Well, as far as like last CD, that was way more scatterbrain. The newer stuff that we have coming out on September 4th.
Kind of harder, wouldn't you think? I think that your last one was kind of harder. No?
It was harder. This album, I mean, there's a song on there that's been the hardest song we've ever written, and then there's some of the stuff that's
the lightest song we've ever written.
Stuff. So, I mean, we're both on either end of the spectrum on this new stuff. So,
and who have you now? This new CD are coming out. Who'd you work with as far as putting it out? And what are you looking forward to as far as promoting it?
Like a label or a producer?
No, as far as producer, I mean, did you have someone who was worked with? You know, you know, SLA or Unseen or someone like that? I mean, who do you have someone that you guys always go to and does your work?
We trade out this guy that's done a lot of sweet CDs that are, he's done it for our friends, like This Providence and Number 12 Looks Like You and Gatsby's. Portugal the Man, it's Casey Bates. And then we went to Kentucky, recorded it for like a month. And then David Bendeth is mixing it. He produced Red Jumpsuit Apparatus and Paramore.
See, there you go. See, I was waiting for you to drop some names. Bands that you've checked out while you've been on tour that you're like, you get done with your set and you're like, you know, I'm gonna go grab a water and maybe I'll go check out their set. Who has caught your ear or that you've like, hey, I'm gonna go check them out, and maybe you check them out the next day also?
Newfound Glory, Starting Line. Alkaline Trio for sure.
Oh yeah.
Killswitch.
Killswitch is awesome.
They're starting here in a little bit. Under Oath. They're on here for a little bit. Can't think of anyone else right now.
If I was to sneak in to check out your MP3 player, your iPod, what would I hear on it?
Mine would be a lot of hip hop.
What?
A lot of hip hop.
Get out of here, really?
Yeah.
Like who?
Just radio stuff. Everything that's like new, top 40, whatever.
This band out of Philly called Blue Collar. They're really good, real catchy. I like it.
Any names that maybe we may not have seen or heard that you've seen on tour and you're like going, wow, what, you know, people don't know how great these guys are, you know, and you know, you guys enjoy them? Well, they're different.
I'd say Human Abstracts, a more unheard of band, but they're kind of out there. They're super talented.
Yeah, they're really good.
When you guys, now this is your a big tour for you, when you guys are kicking back, other than checking out other bands, what are you guys doing? Are you guys kicking, are you guys just snoozing? You guys got a box action going on, or do you guys have some kind of secret key to Wi-Fi somewhere that nobody else has?
Luckily, our bus has Wi-Fi on it, which is nice, but we have an Xbox, we chill on that.
Boozing.
A lot of just boozing, watching TV, hanging out, going to the barbecue every night.
These guys know how to live. You guys know how to live. When you guys get done with here, what are we doing again?
We're taking 3 weeks off. Brad, our keyboard player, is getting married
to my sister.
So that should be fun. It'll be busy.
Then we're doing two headlining tours.
And what are those tours?
One will be with Devil Wears Prada, and that's for like smaller cities. And then that'll be full U.S. Then after that, Emory and Scary Kids, and then that's full U.S. as well in bigger cities.
And then that'll take us up to December, and then I know next year we'll be in Australia in February, and probably doing Japan and Europe, all that stuff too, so.
Now, have you guys been out of the country before, and tell us about the experience, and have you been to Australia, and what are you looking for, mate?
We've been to U.K. twice.
And Holland.
Holland was fun.
Yeah.
To Germany. I got to see like this huge cathedral, and my family's German, and I can say this because German people stink.
Okay, what was it like? What's the difference between American crowds and maybe the UK crowd?
UK crowd's kind of, it's different. I don't know, like.
Girls are slutty.
Yeah, they are. They're very direct.
Yeah.
You say it like it's a bad thing.
I'm married, so I'm not into that.
Are you really? How long? What's your name?
Andrea, and I've been married to her for a year and a couple months.
Want to say hey? I mean, she may never see this, but you want to say hey to her?
Hey, babe, what's up?
There we go. See, you got to show some love. Hey, we're about family here, too. We're a family channel or something. Anything else, guys, as far as Boston? Is this your first time in Boston?
Oh, no.
And your thoughts as far as playing in Boston?
Love it. It's a nice city. I have a friend that goes to Berkeley, so. It's nice to hang out here and hang out with some friends, and Boston's a good town.
How's the press been to you guys?
Today, it's been nice.
Other than the spanking.
I got the spanking.
Now, you're saying it like it's a bad thing. Now, honestly, I had to wear a collar earlier. We all got to pay our dues. What was that like?
Definitely a first.
If there's anything that you wanted to kind of close out the segment with, what would it be, guys?
September 4th, go buy our new CD. Bowman Palace Ballet, and hopefully enjoy it.
Stay tuned. We're going to have more interviews here at the Warped Tour. Don't go far.
All right. I'm Matt.
And I'm Jason.
And we're from Chiodos.
And you're watching On The Road with WHCA.
So stay tuned.
I'm moved when I see ya. You got a feeling. Oh, troubled with the TV on. Feel so devastated and activated. Oh, come on, come on, then see some action. I say it's no secret. Like a clock needs a time. Like white needs black. If you leave, I hope you need to come back. Oh, I swear I know I believe it. Oh, I'm somewhere, don't worry, I'll be there. You rock this party all night. You rock it till there's light up in the air. Fight in the good fight. Cause we were singing along to Peter Gabriel's Sledgehammer song.
Hey everybody, this is your Lady V here, and we are back at the Warped Tour, and I am with
Bryce from Bryce. The Rocket Summer.
The Rocket Summer, how are you today?
I'm doing very well. How are you?
I'm good. I mean, I'm meeting a whole bunch of people, a whole lot of bands. This has been a really exciting day for us
here.
So how's the tour been so far?
The tour has been incredible. At first, I was a little skeptical at first because historically, you know, Warped Tour is like a punk tour, and we're not necessarily like a punk band. But when we got here, we realized that it was so diverse, and it's actually like a perfect place for us to be. We fit in very well, and like we have like really warm,
so
really warm reception.
So, what kind of music does the Rocket Summer Band do? I mean, if you're not punk, what would you call yourselves?
I mean, it's like rock. It's like melodic pop, rock and roll with emotion and passion. And it's driving. It's very, very driving.
Oh, that's pretty cool.
Yeah.
So, how long has your band been together? How long have you guys been?
Well, it's actually funny. Like, I actually play all the instruments on the records and stuff. It's kind of like
a one-man
project
band
of mine. But and I put out my first CD when I was 16. I'm 24 now, so it's been kind of a while. That was like in '99 or 2000, and but it's been amazing. And as far as my band. All my best friends are with me, so we've been doing it for kind of a while. So.
That's pretty cool. Now you guys are from Texas.
From Texas.
And what's the whole scene in Texas like versus something like Boston? Have you been here enough to really tell the difference or anything?
I mean,
like
it's just
that?
So different. The East Coast and the South, you know, it's just so different. Like America's got so many different kinds of countries in itself, you know.
Yeah.
And I feel like Boston's definitely its own thing, just like Texas is definitely its own thing. But yeah, we tour so much, like we're on tour all the time, that I'm like almost a little out of the loop when it comes to like the Texas scene or the Boston scene. I mean, we play Texas, we play Boston, but we just roll in and roll out. So we've been on tour like relentlessly for like the past like 4 or 5 years. So
that's cool. Now, do you have any projects coming up, like new albums or anything like that we can look forward to?
Well, I actually just had a new album come out like 2 weeks ago. So a brand new album just came out. It's called Do You Feel? I'm really proud of it, and you should pick it up.
Definitely want to pick that up. Now, are you online? Like, do you have a MySpace page or?
Yeah, we have a website, therocketsummer.com, and a myspace.com/therocketsummer. So pretty accessible. So come be our friend on MySpace and come check out the website.
I'm sure you're going to get about like 100 friend requests pretty soon.
Nice.
And I'm sure you get that anyway. Like you open it up and you're just like, friend request. So you get approve everybody.
Yeah.
So is there any bands here that you've heard that you're like, wow, these guys are great that you haven't heard yet? Or any like new guys that, like local bands? I know some people just got on the tour within there were some that today's the first day.
Oh, wow.
Some people, fifth day.
Yeah.
Like, have you seen any bands that really caught your ear? Like, wow, I got to hear these guys.
Yeah, I mean, there's like some huge bands that like everybody knows, like Under Oath, you know, they're way cool.
Yep.
Way cool. And then, Some smaller, newer bands, kind of like Megan Dia, are really cool. And but then like some more heritage-y bands like Hot Rod Circuit are really awesome. So it's definitely really cool to be on tour with so many cool bands.
Now, you said you'd perform all your own instruments on the album and everything like that. So is touring a time for you to just sit back and work on the next project? I mean, since it's an all you, well, not all you, but maybe 90% of you, like, is that the time where you just sit back on the bus and you can just, like, play some tunes?
Well,
and
yeah,
really...
I have a piano back in the back lounge, or not a piano, a keyboard in the back lounge of the bus, and I'm not to that point yet, just because the record just came out, and I'm just so, like, consumed with all things, like,
right, this,
but in a few months, I'm going to get back into that, in the swing of things, and
start
writing, so I have it there, just, I have it on deck, just in case
yeah.
I get inspired.
Now, if it wasn't music, and if you weren't on the tour, what do you see yourself doing? Like, what would you have been doing instead if you were to do something else?
Man, I don't know, because it's, like, all I've done for so long, you know, but probably something with, like, mission work or just, like, wanting to help out people who need help, you know. It's a huge part of what the Rocket Summer is about, is wanting to bring hope through music. And so if I wasn't doing that through music, hopefully I'd be doing it some
in
other
general.
Way.
Well,
yeah,
that's pretty
yeah.
cool.
So,
I mean,
we'll see.
That's probably a really
I'm sure it'll happen one day.
I'm sure you're doing it now with your songs anyway.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
that's really, really great.
Awesome.
And after the tour, you going on the road again, or are you just...
Yeah, we're going out for 3 months with the Academy Is, which is going to be awesome. And there's talks about going to the UK, and then the year's like over. So we'll see. We'll see after that.
What's one of the most interesting places you've been to so far? It doesn't have to be Boston, but in general, like from your touring
days. Boston is very interesting. interesting, let's see. I've always thought Long Island is really interesting.
Yeah.
Because it's just like its own thing, man. It's like, it's its own world on its own little planet. Just the people out there. And then we've been to Japan, and we've been to the UK, and we've been to Ireland and stuff. And been all over the place. It's been really amazing. It's a huge blessing to get to like travel the world and play music. But yeah, there's been a lot of interesting places. But as far as in the U.S., the most interesting, for whatever reason, for whatever you want to take it for, is definitely Long Island. It's interesting.
Interesting.
I like Long Island. It's just like
right.
It's crazy how its own thing it is. You know, the people and everything. It's kind of cool.
All right. So, did you get to perform already? You're performing later.
We're performing at 6:30.
Oh, so you're on pretty soon.
Yeah.
All right. So we're gonna let you go,
okay.
So you can warm up and
yeah,
get ready
yeah.
to bless us with whatever you got on the stage.
Awesome. Cool.
And we are here with Rocket Summer Band, and stay tuned. We have so much more here. If you want to say bye or say anything to the fans, you may.
Thanks for watching. Be my friend on MySpace. /therocketsummer.com.
And what's the title of the new album?
The new album's called Do You Feel.
Do
it's
You
in
Feel?
It's in stores everywhere.
It's in stores?
Yeah.
Check it out. I'm going to pick up my copy. You got to go pick up yours,
yeah.
All right? So stick around. More from the Warped Tour.
Hey, what's up? This is Bryce from the Rocket Summer, and you're watching On The Road with WHCA. So stay tuned.
Yeah.
it's like winding down here at the Warp Tour. But guess what? We have Escape the Fate with Max and Ronnie.
That's right. What's going on, everyone?
What's going on?
I like it.
That was a good exclamation point to the sentence. I like it. What's going on, guys?
Not much. Just hanging out here on Warp Tour, enjoying ourselves really a whole lot. A lot of good bands.
Yes.
Just soaking in this nice weather today.
Weather day?
Every day has been really hot.
They're hot.
He's the comedian in the band. Love it, man. What do you guys do when you guys aren't up on stage, you aren't entertaining? Some of the I mean, that's the main reason why we're here talking, but what do you guys like doing when you ain't up on stage? What are the things you guys do to entertain one another?
We drink a lot. I jumped into a pond the other day. I get naked a lot. Fornicate.
We play metal on our bus as loud as we can and just drink and invite people on there and just rage all night.
Rage all night.
Yep.
What do you got coming up after this tour? You guys got a couple things that are up on deck. Talk to them.
Yep, totally. After the tour finishes up, we'll be shooting a music video for a song called Situations. That's off our album, Dying Is Your Latest Fashion. Then after that, we'll be doing a headlining tour with Bless the Fall and a few other good bands. And then after that, we'll be heading out on the Taste of Chaos International with The Used, Rise Against, Aiden, The Bled, Gallows. Yum.
Love it when you get to your antidotes. Yeah. Awesome.
So, talk to me about what the tour has been. How many tours have you done so far, you know, as a band, as far as the Warped Tour?
We were on Warped Tour last year for a little bit, about a month. And before that, we did the Epitaph Records tour with The Matches, The Higher, and I Am Ghost. Before that, we've done a few other tours on our own with a band called Vanna. We did Bamboozle, not the last one, but the year before. Did Bamboozle live.
Just farted. I'm sorry.
Yes, Girls. You did. You just farted.
I did. It's
yeah, but you know, it gives an ambiance to the interview, and that's all we care about.
Okay.
Ambiance, dude.
Just something.
Talk to me about some of the bands that you've been able to, you know, have a camaraderie with. Been able to either you get along with them, you know what I mean, or you hang out together. Talk to me.
Been chilling. The other night, I was hanging out with Claudio from Coheed. Killswitch Engage, real nice guys. This new band just jumped on. Actually, two really good bands just jumped on. Actually, fuck it, three. As It Lay Dying, Still Remains, and Maylene and the Sons of Disaster. All really nice guys.
Really nice guys.
And then another band called The Confession, which we've toured with before. We toured with them in Bullet for My Valentine, and toured with them on our own a few other times. Really great guys. Good to have them back.
Talk to me as far as bands that you like touring with. Who would you say is the best band that you guys usually... If you go on tour with them, or if you met, it's a 1-2 punch.
Oh, man. You know, I don't even, I mean.
It's a chance to give love here.
I mean, well, just like, I mean, those bands I just said, those great bands. We've been on tour with, you know, Bullet for My Valentine, The Confession, The Matches are great guys.
The Matches, The Higher.
Those guys are hilarious.
The Higher is, like, they're all my best. They're most of them are my best friends, like, to tour with. You know, that's a good band.
Usually, I mean, whatever bands, you know, we go on tour with like two or three bands. You know, there's always that one band where it's just you guys are bros and you click. You know, Taylor and a few of the other guys from The Confession, great guys. They love to party and rage and just drink and listen to metal all night, which is rad. That's what we're all about, just partying it up every night.
When there's no partying going on, though, what do you guys like? What do you like doing? I mean, is it just about that? Or
there's never no party.
Tell us what else you like to do. I mean, that... Maybe fans here in Boston wouldn't know, or they wouldn't know from your MySpace. You don't things you don't divulge normally.
Well, cute is what we aim for, and I think it's just great that we rage all night.
I mean, during the day we'll go hang out with the fans and stuff like that, and other bands and stuff, whatever. We'll sit at their merch booth or play some games or whatever. But after the show's over, I mean, we go to the Warped Tour barbecue, stuff like that. We hang out with all the bands. We just like to chill, watch a lot of movies on our bus, you know. Record new ideas and things like that. It's pretty cool. It's a good time. I mean, besides that, a few of the guys in this band called Gallows are always out playing soccer or whatever, which is rad. Sometimes, you know, jump in that, but that's about it, man. We just like to hang out, chill, and then party all night. That's Escape the Fate, cut dry.
Anybody at home, maybe you might want to say a little love to. They may see this, they may not see this, but you could say, hey.
Hi, Emily.
This is the
most beautiful girl I've ever seen in my life.
Yeah, some fans in Boston. Some this really good band called Vanna that's from here in Boston. They're also on Epitaph Records. Great guys. You guys see this? What's up, Chris, Nick, Evan, Brandon, everyone? What's going on?
Nick, Wolverine fell out of my mouth.
What's the movie right now?
Terminator
that's on
2.
The bus? Terminator 2. What else?
Pump up the volume. It's Christian Slater.
We watch that movie like 5 times a day.
Yeah, it's awesome. Braveheart. Dude.
Braveheart.
I said that. Maverick. Anything with Mel Gibson, really. It's awesome.
I'm just waiting for him to say something. He's poised.
Battletoes.
We've been watching Pitch Black and Chronicles of Riddick a lot.
Great movies.
Cool.
Yeah. I like movies a lot.
Awesome. When will you guys get a chance to wind down and relax? Is that coming up or what?
Nope. After this, we shoot that music video, and then we have maybe a week and a half off before our next tour. And then after our headline tour is over, we have 4 or 5 days off before we go back out for 3 months. So this year's pretty much booked, and then after that, we're going to go into the studio and start recording our next album.
MySpace page, homepage?
Yeah, myspace.com/escapethefate. You can check out anything you need there. It's got links to our Smart Punk site where you can buy our merch and things like that. It's got links to everything. It's got links to our iTunes. It's got it all.
What's the hot merch right now?
The hot merch right now is probably our bandanas, our girls' tanks. And, you know, actually on this tour,
you gotta love seeing those out in the crowd.
Oh, yeah, exactly. White tanks, it's the best. You know, everyone's got squirt guns. It's rad.
What's the stuff you guys love seeing in the crowd? What do you encourage in the crowd?
I saw Alf in the crowd. I saw a banana. I saw a guy in a wheelchair crowd surfing.
That's rad.
That's the second time I heard that.
Yep.
That's confirmed.
Yep. I saw...
Was it motorized or was it just one of the little...
pushy things.
Oh, all right. I didn't think the motorized ones.
I saw boobs. I saw.
I think that's the best when bras fly on stage. I like that. That's the best.
Especially big ones. You know what? Buy our album right now because our next one's gonna suck.
There you go. Escape the Fate. More Warp Tour coming back, guys.
We're gonna sound like Devo.
Whip it good. We'll be right back.
What's up? I'm Ronnie.
And I'm Max from Escape the Fate.
And you're watching On the Road with WHCA.
So stay tuned.
Oh! Oh my God!
Thank you guys so much for having me.